Welcome all of you in online teaching learning process. We have started unit number 2, unit operations, which is from paper number 6, industrial chemistry. And in previous video we have covered about the size enlargement technique. And in the case of size enlargement, there are various techniques, that is pellet mill technique. In case of pellet mill, we have also seen, that is ring die mill and flat die mill techniques. In this video we will see, that is tumbling agglomeration. In case of tumbling agglomeration, first we will see agglomeration technique. We know that is agglomeration happens when small particles stick together forming aggregates which are of larger size. Simply, agglomeration means when smaller particles combine with each other, we are getting larger particles. This technique is called as agglomeration. Then in case of tumbling agglomeration, first we will see the principle of tumbling agglomeration. When powder mass along with suitable binder is mixed and tumbled, the binding surface tension forces or cohesive forces are developed which result in agglomeration. So simply, in the case of tumbling agglomeration, the small powder material combined together in the presence of suitable binder. So this is the phenomenon of tumbling agglomeration. So this is the diagram of tumbling agglomeration. In the case of tumbling agglomeration, this is the first diagram, tumbling agglomeration, and second one is a press agglomeration. So press agglomeration, that is pellet mill technique, we have seen last video, which depends on the compaction technique. And in case of tumbling agglomeration, there is no any pressure applied, so this is a non-compaction technique. So this is the difference between tumbling agglomeration and press agglomeration. That is, in case of tumbling agglomeration, no any pressure is applied. So this is a non-compaction technique. So next we will see mechanism of tumbling agglomeration. In case of tumbling agglomeration, fine powders are converted into granule masses by mixing it with a liquid phase, that is a binder, followed by suitable agitation. So in the first case, mechanism followed by, that is fine powders are converted into granule masses by mixing it with a liquid binder, followed by suitable agitation. Then what is agitation? That is, agitation means the tumbling, that is rolling, maybe vibrating or shaking, and cascading action of disc, cone or drum takes place. An exact amount of liquid binder is to be spread. The binder holds small particles together, creating a larger particles. By using binder, that is suitable liquid phase, these small particles combine with each other and we are getting larger particles. In wet agglomeration, the initial moist feed is in the form of aggregates which form into the nuclei in early stage of agitation, which follows with layering or deposition of layers of the material into previously formed nucleus. That is actual mechanism which will be shown in next slide. So the nucleation and layering process is shown below. So in the case of this, an exact amount of liquid binder, so this is a binder droplet are spread on the powder material, initial small fine powder material, and after the action of agitation, that is a rolling. After rolling, these small particles combine with each other and we are getting liquid bridge, and after that liquid bridge, after drying or solidification, we are getting solid bridge. And after that solid bridge, we are getting layer formation. So this is the first layer, and after the layer formation we are getting pellets. So this is the mechanism involved in doubling agglomerators. So in next diagram, that is the technique, that is a powder material, in which first case is the spraying takes place, then second, after spraying, binder liquid is spread, then in second step liquid bridge, that is moistening process takes place, and after moistening we are getting solid bridge, it is called a solidifying process, and after that we are getting special solid structure, that is large particles, it is called as agglomeration. So this is the mechanism involved in agglomeration. Then in case of tumbling agglomeration, also tumbling agglomeration, there are two types, that is it is classified into inclined pan agglomerator and drum agglomerator. Then we will see one by one. First we will see inclined pan agglomerator. It consists of inclined pan rotating about its axis, as shown in the diagram below. That is, it consists of inclined pan. This is an inclined pan. This is an inclined pan rotating about its axis. This is the axis. This pan rotating about its axis. It is inclined at about 45 degree. The angle between them is a 45 degree. Then powder raw material is fed from the hopper. Then fine powder material is inserted from this. That is the equipment that is called as hopper. That is, feed is provided from this hopper. Then material rolls over a nucleus particle to form balls. When this feed material is passes into this pan, then pan is, that is a rotating at an angle of 45 degree. So during this rotation, rollover or nucleus formation takes place, and there is a formation of ball takes place. And after the formation of ball, these balls will be exited, that is enlarged balls roll up the pan, exited from this pan after formation of larger size balls. So in this case, fine powder material seals down through the large balls and remain in the pan. But during this, when large balls are away from the pan, during this process fine dust particles remains in the pan as it is. So this is the working phenomenon of inclined pan agglomerator. Then we will see advantages of inclined pan agglomerators. In case of advantages, first one, without screen, a uniform shaped product is separated. That is, no screening will be takes place here, or no any screen is applied here to obtain specific size. So without screening, uniform shape product will be obtained. Then second advantage is the equipment is very simple to control and have very low cost. And third one, it is easy to observe the balling action. We will see the mechanism easily. And one drawback, that is disadvantage, is it produces dust particles. So this is about the inclined pan agglomerator. Then next one is a drum agglomerator. Below the diagram of the drum agglomerator. So first one, as the drum rotates, so here is a drum which is a circular in shape, which is circular, which rotates in clockwise direction. Then there is a bars means the rod cage. So this rod cage is called as bars. Lift the fine powders and create a falling curtain of the smaller and dry particles. So in the first case, when drum rotates in clockwise direction, during this rotation through this rod cage, there are several rod cage available, through this rod cage fine powders up and forms a falling curtain, as like this will be formed, and the liquid binder is spread through this spray droplet. When fine powder come from this rod cage, then falling curtain will be formed, and on this fine powder, liquid binder will be spread, as like shown in this diagram. And during this process, fine powders agglomeration process agglomerate, that is fine powder converting to large particles, and we are getting bigger particles. In this way, continuing rotation of drum produces larger particles. So in case of drum agglomerator, in this process we are converting small particles into bigger particles by using this mechanism. So this is the drum agglomeration process. So in the case of drum agglomeration has the following advantages over a pan agglomerator. It has a large capacity and it has a large retention time if required. And drum agglomerator also have some disadvantage, that is particles of various size are produced. So screen is required to separate enlarged particles from the smaller particles. So in the case of drum agglomerators, we are getting bigger particles, but their size is not uniform. So some special screen, that is some special parameters will be needed to get specific shape and size of that material. So this is about the drum agglomerators. So thank you all of you for listening this video.